OPPO Find X, can this flagship really challenge the Galaxy Note 9 and Mate 20 Pro? OPPO Find X has finally arrived in the UK and is the Chinese firm's flagship device that takes aim at the Galaxy Note 9 and Huawei Mate 20 Pro, but can it really compete with the best? OPPO cemented its arrival in the UK last week when the tech giant held an event at Tower Bridge showcasing some of its smartphone offerings. While the firm showed off its budget RX17 Neo and mid-tier RX17 Pro handsets respectively, the star of the show was by far its Find X flagship. The OPPO Find X first released back in June last year but is now available to purchase in the UK. And with a price tag of £799, the hardware is certainly positioned to compete with some of the best smartphones on the market, such as the Galaxy Note 9 and the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. Express.co.uk attended OPPO's recent London exhibition and was able to go hands-on with the Find X. By far the most unique feature offered by the device is its motorized slider that allows users to take advantage of the phone's front and rear-facing cameras. The unique characteristic allows the Find X to deliver fans an all-screen design. OPPO claims the product flaunts a 93.8% screen-to-body ratio. Find X comes with a 6.42-inch AMOLED panel that, during Express.co UK's testing, offered good viewing angles and vibrant colors. The resolution of the screen is 1080p and its density is 401 pixels per inch. Powering the Find X is a Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 and not the manufacturer's latest and greatest 855 processor. The flagship also arrives with 8GB of RAM and an Adreno 630 GPU. OPPO's top-tier device comes with two rear-facing cameras, with the primary one being 16 megapixels in quality while the secondary is 20 megapixels. Moreover, the phone also comes with a 25-megapixel front-facing camera. Finally, the handset also has a 3,730 mAh battery that should allow for an entire day of usage. The Find X is certainly one of the best smartphones on the market at the moment from a design standpoint. During our hands-on session, the device looking stunning in either its Bordeaux red or glacier blue finishes. Because the device's cameras are housed under its motorized slider, it means the Find X looks asymmetrical, sleek, and futuristic. But although this publication did not have enough hands-on time to deliver a final verdict on the device, its introduction in the UK at this moment in time is strange for a few reasons. First and foremost, the device was first introduced in June last year and is therefore already over 6 months old. It is expected a successor to the Find X will be unveiled at around the same time in the year as the original was. This means it may only be a few months until the Find X is surpassed by what OPPO has up its sleeve next. Secondly, the hardware's age means it is powered by Qualcomm's Snapdragon 845 and not the 855 processor that will presumably power most Android flagships this year. This means while the Find X will surely offer great performance across Google's Android operating system, it will certainly not be industry-leading by any means. Finally, the use of motorized parts within the handset leaves us questioning the longevity of such a device. Every time users want to unlock the handset via facial recognition or take a selfie, the motor is being used. The reliance on such a small part means using the phone's cameras may be problematic if it ever fails. So while Express.co.uk cannot deliver our final thoughts on the Find X yet, our brief time with the device left us with a few concerns. This means at the moment we would recommend flagships from OPPO's rivals for those in the market for a new Android device. However, this publication does plan to test the Find X in more detail and publish a full review for it in the near future.